Now I just have to remove this and then use the lookup, leveraging the broadcast variable. So if you want to use broadcast variable, so what you are supposed to do is, instead of so these steps have to be used. So we have to read data from the local file system. We need to read the data from that file and then split using the new line character and delimiter. And then we have to create a typical Python list. So in this case, products is a typical Python list. From this, I have to convert into a dict and I need to broadcast. And instead of joining, using this revenue by product ID, I can apply map function. And as part of lambda functions for that map, I can actually do a lookup into the broadcast variable. Okay, so this will change. Now what we are supposed to do is convert products into dict and broadcast, use revenue by product ID and apply map function. As part of lambda in map, we will do lookup into broadcast variable. Okay, so and then we will be getting the product name, and then we'll save the output to the final path. Okay, so first what we have to do, I am actually creating products dict, and then I am actually using this products, which is Python collection, and then I am applying map function on top of it. Okay, this is Python map function, this is not Spark map function. So Python map function take two arguments. The first one is lambda function and the second one is the iterable, which is nothing but collection. So products is iterable and we are passing that to this map function, and as part of first argument we have to pass lambda function, and then we have to create a list of tuples which will contain product ID and name, and then we will convert into dict by passing this entire collection of tuples into the constructor called dict. Okay, so in this case I can say int of p dot split of comma is the delimiter. And the first element in the tuple will be product ID, and the second element will be product name, which is nothing but p dot split of one. Once you apply the map function, now we can actually say dict and it will become a dictionary. Once you get this dictionary, what you can do is you can say, let me check. I forgot the syntax. Let me pick it up real quick. Once you get the dict, you just have to create a variable, and then you can say sc.broadcast. And for that broadcast, you can actually pass a dictionary which we have created. Okay. Once you do this, what will happen is when this code is executed, as you guys are aware, all the Spark APIs are deferred until action is performed. So, for example, in this code, you should be able to separate Spark code and regular Python code. Okay. So from here, this is regular Python code. This is regular Python code. This is regular Python code which will create this Spark context. Okay. And then all these file validations are regular Python code using HDFS APIs. And then the first API, which is Spark API, is text file where we are trying to read the order data. And then we applied filter and then map. Okay. So this will be added to DAG. If you recollect, whenever you apply transformations of Spark, it will not be executed immediately. It will only update a DAG. Okay, so this is a Spark code. So this will not be executed immediately. And even this one, a function will be created, but this function will not be executed until it is executed at a later point in time when action is performed as part of executors. Okay, all you need to understand is this will not be executed immediately. And then if you go further down, again, this is all Spark API. This will also be not executed immediately. It will be added to the DAG. And then here, this one is regular Python code. And hence, it will be executed immediately. Okay. And once it is executed immediately, it will also execute this one. This is also regular Python code. And when you say sc.broadcast, by this time, sc is nothing but Spark context. It actually procured all the resources for you. The executors, pre-allocating memory, and all those things. As you say broadcast, this dictionary will be broadcasted immediately. Even before rest of the stuff is executed, this dictionary products dict will be broadcasted to all the executors. And then wherever this dictionary is being used as part of your logic, at that time it will be used for lookup, and then it will be leveraged as part of data processing, as part of execution of Spark API. Okay. So in this case, instead of now using Parallel and creating RDD for products, we don't want to do it. The products is already broadcasted to the executors in which the data will be processed when the action is performed. So far, we haven't performed any action yet. Okay. So we'll come back to this save as text file later. I am commenting it out. It is not required at this time. We'll come back to that. And I'm deleting this. We don't need to parallelize anymore here. Okay. So now what you are supposed to do is take revenue by product ID. Okay. And then as part of the math function, you will be passing a lambda function for it. Let's say, what is the variable name I have used here? Product. Okay. Product revenue. Let me use it as product revenue. Okay. And then this BV, we should be able to use this BV as part of this lambda function. So what is this BV? BV is nothing but a broadcast variable, and the value which we have passed as BV is nothing but a dict. So to access this dict, we have to say BV dot value. Okay, so this BV dot value will return whatever is broadcasted by using SC dot broadcast. In this case, we have passed a dict, and hence BV will be of broadcast variable, but BV dot value will be the dict. Once you get the dict, so for example, if you have dict like this, P equal to 1 product 1 and then 2 product 2. So we have broadcasted something like this. Okay, so BV dot value will return something like P. Once you get that P, which is after dict, to access the value, you can say P of 1. It will give the corresponding value for that one. And if you say P of 2, it will give corresponding value for 2. Okay, now BV dot value is like that P. Now if I say BV dot value, and then if I specify product revenue of 0. So what is product revenue of 0? If you go here, you can see here revenue by product ID is nothing but the output of joining orders filtered for a month, and then using product ID computing the revenue. So if you actually follow this logic, the output is something like this: product ID and revenue. Okay, so in this case, revenue by product ID is nothing but RDD of these things. There will be a bunch of product IDs and revenue. So now we are processing this RDD, which contains product ID and revenue. And as part of the processing, I am trying to do the lookup into the broadcast variable, which is of type dict, by passing this information. How to pass that information? By saying BV dot value, which is nothing but dict, and then I am passing the product ID, which will give us the product name. Once you give the product, once you get the product name here, you can concatenate with whatever delimiter you want. So in this case, we are using tab as delimiter. Okay, and then we can actually concatenate the revenue also by saying product revenue of 1, but it is of type float, and hence we have to typecast to string. So I have to use string here, and now you will get the final output after this math function. Okay, after this math function, the final output will be something like this. So I'm printing the results here. I am iterating through it for IN, revenue by product ID, blah blah blah, and then I am actually printing I. Okay, once we see these results on the screen, then we will actually use save as text file and save it into the file system. You can see here we got till we got product ID, not name. So this I need to troubleshoot. So product revenue. Okay, the reason why we are getting numbers here is if you look at the products data, it has 6 or 7 fields. The first field is product ID, second field is product category ID, third field is product name, and in this case it is printing the product category ID, but we actually need product name. Okay, so I have to just change it to 2. So it's just a bug in the code. I figured out the issue. Now if you say run, it actually gives us the name. Also, meanwhile, I just want to clean up some of the code which I have updated earlier to troubleshoot the issue, like these two print statements. And now you can see that we got product name and revenue associated with it for the month which we have asked for. Okay, so now I can use this, and I can delete this for loop, and also I can remove all these things. Okay, and then I can apply save as text file, and I should be able to save the output into the file. Okay, and now you should be able to see the output. In this case, the path which I have given as an argument is nothing but user site diversity research data, and in that data we have monthly revenue. If you go to the monthly revenue here, and if you open these files with Sublime text, you should see the name and revenue. Okay.